it's just Mark Gonzalez. It's hard to like input into words what he's like. He's completely unique in his skateboarding and the way he is as a person.
Oh yeah! Banana!
He's just not like anybody else.
It's like, is there ever a bad photo of Mark, you know? Every photo of Mark is an instant classic, pretty much.
Maybe check, maybe four, maybe five, maybe six.
When I'm shooting photos with him, I can see like he's totally improvising, so you can't really plan to take a photo with him because it's not gonna work.
Pretty much once he gets going, you just have to leave the camera running because everything he does on and off the board is entertaining. I mean, a lot of people, it's just about their tricks, but his is like the whole everything.
Yeah, we're working on this new video. It's called Act Your Age. Watch this firecracker.
Mark will be really excited about whatever he's trying or wants to try, because he'll be trying one trick and then, oh, change his mind and try a trick the other way. Or try this unicycle, or gonna try this bicycle.
You never know what's gonna happen, but you know something's gonna happen if you're out with him.
He kind of like drags people in to his little world, you know, and they're just like enamored by him. You know, like, oh, what's this guy doing?
He has a way with people he's never met before. There's an instant connection. He connects to people in a very unique and instant way.
Bonjour, monsieur.
Oh, merci.
Hello, oui. C'est Marc de Paris.
So he was trying to skate this spot, and he was just struggling with whatever trick he was trying. And he got really angry at his shoes, so he started to have this conversation with his shoes, and at one point he threw them in the air, I think, probably to punish them. He doesn't differentiate between animate and inanimate objects. I think he has the same relationship with all of them.
I do the tricks, not you!
He sees skateboard like the first time, always. Whenever he grabs a board, it's like the first time he skateboards. He's not conditionated by anything, by tricks, by videos or anything. He's just free to do whatever.
He skates boards that are like broken or bigger or just different shapes to kind of like make skateboarding more interesting for him. And he can skate anything.
For the circle board in Paris, he wanted to do it in that area, which is the most crowded plaza in Paris. So we met at 6 in the morning, like before sunrise, hoping that it would be quiet. What we didn't know is Mark actually skated all the way from the place he was staying at with the circle board and was already skating when we showed up. We rolled this like 6 stairs or whatever. I was like, let's shoot a sequence of it in 1 minute. The light's gonna be amazing. He was like, oh no, it's too hard. I can't do it again. And then when the sun was actually almost nice, he was like, okay, that's it. Let's go home. And he literally went down the hill there with it. And we skated 20 blocks back. Sometimes Mark does stuff and you're in the moment and it's so natural for him to do it, but you just realize there that it's actually totally out of human comprehension.
You have insurance? I'm covered by Medi-Cal. Okay, good.
It's pretty crazy too how good he is at getting out of dangerous situations.
There's a million times where I've seen him almost get hit by a car or go under a car or a tractor trailer or truck. But that happens so frequently when you're with Mark that you just get used to it. Like you just, yep, he'll be fine.
You take a really beefy gnarly slam and get up and go again.
Mark had this idea to build a platform across the Brooklyn banks in New York. They attached it to the handrails, the two handrails going down. So it's like a bank, a deck, and a bank. And it started raining. And everyone else like that was there skating, like Van and Bobby and those dudes would be like, dude, we can't skate this thing. This is way too gnarly. It's too wet, it's like too dangerous, someone's gonna get hurt. And I think he was trying to manual across it and he slipped out, flew in the air, and right next to the deck they built and the stairs and the bank, it's like this granite curb. And Mark, as fast as you could, out of control, flying through the air, just hit.
Boom.
So hard, like everything shook. These kids actually said something to him, and Mark just gave him a really like intense look and held up his hand and blood was just pouring out of his hand. And he's like, you gotta bleed to get paid.
Listen, dude, I got this on. Have you heard that one? It's the grime music. Dude, I want to put it to skateboarding. I'm going to make a video for YouTube. You know that one song goes push, push. Now coast, coast, push, push, coast.
A big memory from Reel to Reel was just Gabe making fun of all the excuses Mark had to not go film. Like his cat was depressed or he had to wash his dishes all day. Just things like that.
About to attack this double set.
You. Once you got him out, he ripped for sure.
Mark awling over Max on the motorcycle. It was rough, so we needed speed. So Max would tow him in, and then he'd ollie. So a couple times, and just figured out the timing and the speed, and then it just worked out.
I got a call from Adidas that Mark was going to be in Cologne doing this. They didn't really know what it was. He did the museum on a Sunday. He skated the streets on a Monday, and the rest of the week then, we just went around Germany. He was doing these talks, like spoken words, in auditoriums all through southern Germany. The really gnarly, gnarly high-end German modern art museum. All the stuff that was on the floor is worth millions and millions of dollars, and then he's just skating around it. I think they were like worried that, you know, things were gonna get hurt in there. Everyone at Trans was like, oh, you gotta get a skate photo, you need to get a skate photo, and he can't remember skating the rail. And I think I made him skate the rail to get a skate photo. Now I look at it, and it wasn't about the skate photo at all. It was about Mark in a fucking fencing outfit going around Cologne. It was almost like more like a performance art.
Kick it real hard.
We've been in Melbourne filming Silas, and out of a sudden, Mark just started filming Silas with his laptop. He's not filming for like 1, 2, 3 tries. He's filming like until Silas gets his trick done. And after filming it every night, like Mark went home and does like his own skate videos. He's super productive. He's skating, he's filming. He's like entertaining people in the bus, talking to everyone. It's really good to have him on the tour. It's always good times, always good times.
He's gonna skateboard till he can't walk. Then he might be like probably pushing himself on his hands or something. You know, he's never gonna stop. I don't think he can stop, you know?
Now I know you are a master. what he said. I don't wanna.
No, I consider this work right here.
Okay, light's green.
More than sacred, the blues. It's only me and you. Don't cry, we'll think of something.
Each person interprets poems their own way.
Open to new ideas and ready to shoot my face off. I remember trying to be a lover of words. The poems smelt like flowers. What kind of freak are you? I feel relieved. I'm happy and dumb.
Okay, people, come on up. We're gonna boogie.